Friends, today we are going to discuss the new topic of chapter 5, that is decentralization. What is the meaning of decentralization? Everything which goes to increase the importance of subordinate's role is decentralization, and everything that goes to reduce the importance of subordinate, it is centralization. So we can understand here, if we are increasing the role of subordinate, it is decentralized. When we are decreasing the role of subordinate, this is centralization. So what is the meaning of importance here? Importance means decision taking power or decision taking authority. If we are giving to subordinate, we are decentralized organization. If we are keeping with us, top management is keeping with them, it is called centralized organization. And practically, if we see, we have not seen any organization which is completely centralized or completely decentralized. So we have to keep balance between the centralization and decentralization. For the routine kind of work, we can give this authority to subordinates, and for the important policy decisions, we can keep this authority with ourselves. So we have to keep balance between centralization and decentralization. Some parts we have to keep with ourselves only, means top management will keep themselves, like policy decisions and some kind of routine works or routine decisions, they can delegate this thing to their subordinates. Let's try to understand the importance of decentralization with the help of these points. First develops initiative among the subordinates. We can see here in decentralization process, the subordinates is getting some authority to take decision on the basis of his own judgment, and like that way he can develop himself for the solution to develop the solution of various problem which he is facing in routine life or day-to-day work. And like that way, what happened? This policy is helping out or taking out the potential of the subordinates. He can work efficiently, or we can taking out their talents by the way of giving them chance to take decision. And like that way, their self-reliance will be increased, that confidence will be also increased, and like that way it is in favor of the organization. And like that way we are also preparing the dynamic leaders for the future. All right, next is develops managerial talent for the future. So we can see that when we are using decentralization of authority, at that time subordinates is getting the authority to take decision, and he is developing himself for getting the promotion of higher position. And like that way, and this thing is creating the reservoir of talents by the decentralization of authority. There will be many persons or many talented person will be developed the managerial skill, because we are giving them chance by the way of decentralization. And here, by the way of this, he is also getting the experience here getting for the handling of different kind of assignments independently. And like that way he is getting chance to prove himself that how much ability he has and how much he is able to face the challenges that are coming in front of his position or in front of an organization. Like that way he can develop himself, he can develop the manager skill, and the future leaders are ready, we are keeping ready for the future. Next is quick decision making. Here, what is the meaning of quick decision making? Here we are giving authority to take decision to subordinates. That means they can take quick decision. So decisions are taken on the problem where the problem they are facing. So they don't have to ask to the upper level or their subordinates to take decision. They are taking decision. So decision taking process is becoming very fast. And like that way, they don't have to share the information also. And there is no chance no chance of distorting any kind of information, because they don't have to share with many levels or many persons. And here they can also take decision very fastly and adopt the changing environment of business. And like that way, we can take that the decision taking process is becoming a fast. Why? Because they are getting power, they are getting authority to take decision. They don't have to ask to their superiors and many superiors. And like that way, they don't have to pass through the long channels. And like that way, this process is becoming fast. Next is relief to top management. Like here, the top management is sharing the authority of taking power with their subordinates, so that what happened, they will get time to face to focus on the policy decisions, and they can give the authority to take decision for the day-to-day routine life or for the operational work. They can give the authority to subordinates, and they get time to focus on the policy decisions. And like that way, the top management workload is reduced, and for that purpose they can focus on planning, they can focus on coordination, they can focus on controls in the activities of different departments. And like that way, they can also reduce the workload of managers. Now, next one is facilitate growth. How decentralization is facilitating growth? Facilitating with the growth by the way of diversification of activity, because we can diversify the activity by creating new departments, new divisions, or we can also launch new product or services, and consequently there will be a growth for the organization. And like that way, we can also our returns, more returns will be there. And if we are getting more returns at that time, there is a scope of growth, and all these things are possible only and only when we are doing decentralization. And due to decentralization, what happened, we are able to increase the productivity level, and we are also able to increase the ability of organization. And like that way, there is a growth of organization. The next and last one is that is a better control. How the decentralization is useful for better control? Because when in the case of control, we already have the standards. We are setting standard for the measurement of performance, and like that way, every division or every unit has some standard, set standard, and here we can compare the standards with their actual performance. And like that way, we can easily find out the any deviation is there, and we can also get time to take the corrective action if it is required. Because through the decentralization, we can easily fix the responsibility given to a person, and he is accountable for their result. And like that way, we can also calculate the what kind of contribution is given by the each department to meet the objectives of the organization. And like that way, there we can develop the systematic controlling system by the way of decentralization. Ultimately, at last, we can come to the conclusion that decentralization is benefited only and only when we have to apply with the caution. Why? Because it may be lead to disintegration of departments if this decentralization is not used with our organizational rules and regulation and guidelines. When these things are used, when the departments are using this authority at this own way, it may be not in interest of the organization. So we have to keep the balance of centralization and decentralization, so that we can get the best benefit of this process. You can easily remember this point with the help of this word that is called See Mr. DG. See Mr. DG is the word I have made to remember all this point. What is meaning of C? Yes, C means better control. M means what? M means develop managerial talent for the future. R means relief to the top management. D means quick decision making. I means develops initiative among subordinate. And G means facilitate growth. Thank you, friends.